Council members, I did submit written testimony online. My name is Catherine Jian. I'm the executive director of the Pacific Alliance to Stop Slavery, and I'm in strong opposition to Bill 59. Aside from the inherent constitutional issues with this ordinance or this proposed bill, in theory, the incentive to create such legislation might have been sound, but in practice, oftentimes policy goes awry. And this piece of legislation would adversely affect, disproportionately affect, not only the poor and the homeless, but also runaway youth and homeless youth. We need to seek other remedies to address poverty that don't criminalize the poor, the homeless, or runaway youth. Hawaii already suffers from exceeding the national average in its incarceration rate of juvenile youth. It's highly serious. Now, steps are underway to reform this justice system problem and not incarcerate at the taxpayers' expense nonviolent offenders. Aside from the fact that we are assigning a fine to those who may not be able to pay for these fines, the answer to this problem shouldn't lie in, oh, well, they can get a slip of paper from a homeless shelter, which are often booked up and unavailable to accept more entries. This policy needs to be more thought out, and it begs deferral for a more critical analysis of its repercussions. Furthermore, the taxpayers will end up, even if it passes, the taxpayers will end up footing the bill for the repercussions adversely that this legislation will incur. Existing laws suffice. This type of legislation is not necessary. The answer lies in adequately addressing poverty, not criminalizing those who are poor. I also caution you that if you do pass out this bill and its amendments, the CD proposals, as is, that you at least amend the bill to exclude juveniles under the age of 18, and if juveniles who are whose only breadwinners are also their homeless parents or single parents who are homeless, and they get fined or incarcerated, that there is adequate addressing and housing and care for those children while their parents may be in incarceration. I also beg you to take a look at past policies that Doug mentioned that have ended up in incarcerating, at our taxpayer dollars, non-violent, honest, and kind people who don't deserve to be in prison with felons and violent offenders. I beg you, I know all of you, or I know of most of you, and I know deep down that you are good people and that you want and you seek good policies that protect our community. As the executive director of the Pacific Alliance to Stop Slavery, I have seen pass state laws, seven of them since 2010, that protect Hawaii's most vulnerable. And I come to you in that regard, that we would like to see the protection furthered of Hawaii's most vulnerable, who cannot be here to speak for themselves. Thank you.
Thank you. Members, any questions for Ms. Jian? Okay, if not, any others here to testify on this measure?